Welcome to the Atlas Copco ToolsTalk MicroTorque tutorial series. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up your ToolsTalk MicroTorque software with your MicroTorque Focus controller. We'll create a Pset, do some rundowns, and check out all of our traces. The first thing that we'll do is connect our MicroTorque Focus controller via USB to our computer. Then we'll power on our controller and open up ToolsTalk MicroTorque. Now that our controller's on, we'll go into the software, click on the USB, and then click the connect button. We just get a message saying that the time differs from our PC time. We'll hit OK. We open up the Pset tab, and we see a list of all the Psets we can set. Pset 1 is set in red. The reason for that is that we created a Pset for a different tool than what's connected now, which is not compatible. I'll double-click on that Pset to open it up. And across the top, we get a message saying this Pset was configured for a tool type other than what we're using. We're using the ETD M200 instead of the ETD M08. We could either edit the Pset and put in the values that work for us, or we could just click Default Pset. I'll click Default Pset to reset it back to its default values for this tool. What we're going to be doing today is running down 7 different screws on this hard drive right here. So I'll go ahead and secure this hard drive to the table. I've already loosened the screws. Perfect. In our software now, we'll make all the changes we want to our Pset. I want my torque target to be 100 centinewton meters. It automatically changes our maximum torque to 108. That's okay. Our tightening speed to 250 RPM. I like that as well. And I'll change the step type from torque step to hard joint step, since this is a hard joint. I'll allow it to be clockwise tightening. We don't have a vacuum set up, so we don't need to worry about that. And then if I go under the global parameters over here, I could change what gets displayed on the actual controller itself, as well as some other things, such as the batch size. We'll change it from 1 to 7, since we have 7 screws on this hard drive. Just by hitting Enter on your keyboard, the changes will save. There is no Store button on this program. Once we're happy with that, we could close that out. I could open up my controller preferences by double-clicking on Controller if I'd like. And we could change the OK beep frequencies and a whole bunch of other settings as well. Everything looks good, though. I'll leave it as is. If you did want to change your display units, you'd change them up here at the top. I like using centinewton meters. Now we'll go up top and I'll open up my trace monitor. We have 2 different windows that open up. The first is the large one that shows us our trace values as they come through. And the second shows us the current torque, the peak torque, and the speed live from the tool itself. You'll notice that this program updates much faster than the other ToolsTalk usually do. So, let's get to work. I'll take my tool, begin my first rundown. A 100 centinewton meters. The screen turns green to indicate that it's been okay. And on our software, we see a live update of the trace. And this is our 7th and final screw. And we get the blue screen saying batch OK. And that's how easy it is to set up a Pset using ToolsTalk MicroTorque and an MT Focus controller. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, leave a comment below and we'll get back to you. Thank you for watching, and be sure to subscribe for more product news and tutorials from Flexible Assembly.